Morning students, in this lecture video I will explain what is pumping lemma. The concept is quite critical, so please try to understand pumping lemma, its application and how to use the concepts. Okay. So first we go through the notes that I have shared to you. Okay, so yeah, this is the notes. So first let us see that what is the use of pumping lemma. I think last week I have sent you this class notes regarding all the topics of regular expressions and regular language. So pumping lemma is one of the most critical concept. So what is the use of pumping lemma? The use of pumping lemma is to basically prove that certain languages are not regular or certain languages are not context free language. So there are basically two variations of pumping lemma. One is that it is used to prove that certain language is not a regular language, and another version is there that we will see in the next chapter, that pumping lemma is also used to prove that certain language is not a context free language. That is slightly a difficult version, a different version of the context pumping lemma for regular language. Okay, so it is basically used to prove that certain languages are not regular, and this is called proof by refutation or proof by contradiction. So what we do first we assume that certain languages are regular language, and then use the conditions or the techniques that have been proposed in pumping lemma, and finally we see that we are not able to fulfill the conditions, and some conditions are there which is not being satisfied. Why is it? Because pumping lemma is false? No, pumping lemma is right. It is only because our original assumption that L is a regular language is a false assumption. Okay, so this is called proof by refutation. First we assume that L is a regular language, then we apply the pumping lemma, and then we see that certain conditions we cannot meet, hence the contradiction, and hence L is not a regular language. Our assumption is wrong, that we will show. State pumping lemma for regular language. I hope you have studied this thing. So now for the time being, please listen. First, what we do, we assume that L is a regular language. So we make the assumption first, and then at the end of the proof, we will show that this assumption is basically a wrong assumption. Okay. Then suppose the language is 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. So if the value of n equal to 3, it will be 0 to the power 3, 1 to the power 3, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, right? So first, what we do, we take a string that belongs to sigma star such that W belong to L. So if L is 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, we take a string W which is in the format of 0 to the power n to the power n. So it may be 0 to the power 3, 1 to the power 3, maybe 0 to the power 4, 1 to the power 4, and so on. Okay, and W is greater than or equal to n. So what is n? I think I already have explained in my regular classes that all regular languages can be represented by what type of automata? Finite automata, right? So if it is representable by a finite automata, then that automata has certain number of states. So how many states are there? Here we assume that n be the number of states in the corresponding finite automata. So if L is a regular language, and so definitely there will be some finite automata which can represent this regular language, and in that case it will have certain number of states. Okay, and that number of states is nothing but n. So if it is a regular language, it can be representable by a finite automata which has n number of states. Now pumping lemma has to maintain 3 to 4 conditions. Please try to understand. First, we take a string W belong to sigma star such that W belong to L. So it may be 0 to the power 3, 1 to the power 3, 0 to the power 4, 1 to the power 4, in generalized format 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, and so on. And W greater than n. Okay, this is the basic condition that we have to fulfill. Also, we take w into three substrings x, y, and z with a condition that mod of x, y has to be less than or equal to n, and y cannot be null, that is y greater than zero. So if these conditions are fulfilled, I mean w equal to x, y, z with the condition of x, y is fulfilled, with the condition of y is fulfilled, if all these conditions are satisfied, then for any integer, I equal to 0, 1, 2, what we have, x, y to the power I, z must belong to L. So suppose the value of I equal to 0, so it will be x, y to the power 0, z, that is x, z. If the value is 1, then x, y, z, obviously belong to L because w equal to x, y, z. Then the value of I equal to 2, so it becomes x, y, y, z. The value of I equal to 3, so it becomes x, y, 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 z. All these strings will belong to the language L. Now, what will be our task, how we solve the problem, is that, please read this thing, it's simple. First, we fulfill all the conditions of the pumping lemma. Then we precisely choose a suitable value for integer I, such that x, y to the power I, z, does not belong to L. That is very, very important. So we have to find out a value for I for which x, y to the power I, z does not belong to L. What does it mean? Pumping lemma is wrong? No, pumping lemma is right. Our assumption is wrong. If L had been a regular language, then x, y to the power I, z must belong to L, whatever be the value for I. So for any particular value of I, if we can show that this does not belong to L, that means our original assumption that L is a regular language is a false assumption. That's what we have explained here, right? So I repeat once again, before we solve the problems, we have to understand the basic facts, which I repeat once again. Number one, okay? So number one is that L is a regular language. Number two, W that belong to sigma star is equal to x, y, z that belong to L with two conditions. Number one, mod of x, z must less than equal to n, and y cannot be null, so mod of y is greater than zero. If these three conditions are fulfilled, that w equal to x, y, z, okay, mod of x, y less than equal to n, and mod of y greater than zero, that is y cannot be null. If all these three conditions are fulfilled, then x, y to the power I, z will belong to L, whatever be the value for I. So what we need to do, we need to find out a value for I such that x, y to the power I, z does not belong to L. And then our intention is fulfilled, that L is not a regular language. That's why x, y to the power I, z does not belong to L. Now we go to the problem once again. Let us see a particular problem. Yes, this one. Okay, so this is the most typical problem. So that 0 to the power I, 1 to the power I greater than or equal to 3 is not a regular language. Students of my batch, I think you know, probably this was the last class that I have taken before the lockdown, that I gave you a problem to design a finite automata for 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, right? And you all had a try for around 20 minutes or 15 minutes. Then I declared that it is not a type 3 language, or it's not a regular language, and hence you cannot design a finite automata. Okay, that is the first time we came to know that finite automata can be designed only if the language is a regular language. Okay. So because S derives ASB or 0S1 or 01, that we have seen, that is not a type 3 language. Here, using pumping lemma, we'll prove it. Okay. So in most of the books, what you will see, that a generalized approach has been given, and that is why students get confused. Basically, most of the books go for this approach, this one, the mathematical approach. And that's students find it a little difficult to understand. So what I have done is basically I have taken a particular example by taking n equal to 3. that will help you to understand better. Okay, so please see the problem. Taking a specific value for n, suppose L is a regular language. Further, we assume that n equal to 3, which is equal to the number of states in the corresponding finite automata. Okay, and we all know that W belong to L and W equal to X, Y, Z, that will W equal to 3 substrings X, Y, Z. Okay, and n equal to 3. So what is W basically? W equal to 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. Okay, that is 0 to the power of 3, 1 to the power of 3. So that is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Now what we need to do, we have to take the value for x, y and z such that all the conditions of pumping lemma are true. What are the conditions? That mod W should be greater than or equal to n. Okay, x, y should be less than or equal to n. Okay, and mod of y should be greater than 0. So now we take mod of W equal to mod of 0 to the power 3, 1 to the power 3. Here mod means length. So what is the length of 0 to the power 1 to the power 3? That is, what is the length of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 6, right? So 6 is greater than equal to n because we all know that the value of n equal to 3. We have assumed it here. So this condition is true, right? Second, we have to take the value for x, y such that mod of x, y should be less than equal to n. That is less than equal to 3. So we have taken x, y is equal to 0, 0, 0. That is 3 less than equal to 3. And also we have taken x equal to 0, 0 and y equal to 0. Okay, so that mod of y equal to mod of 0, that is the length is 1, which is greater than 0. Now many students ask me, sir, how do we choose the value of x, y and z? You can choose in any way. Okay, this is a particular example. You can choose in any way. The only thing is that you have to fulfill these three conditions. Okay, for example, I have taken here x equal to 0, 0. I have taken here y equal to 0. So what is the total length of x and y? The total length of x and y is 0, 0, 0. So the length is 3. Okay, so it is less than equal to 3. It is less than equal to 3. So my condition is fulfilled. You can take any other value, but make sure that the total length of x, y, it cannot be 4. It cannot be 5. It has to be less than equal to 3 because the value of n is 3 here, right? And y cannot be null. Now, if you take x equal to 0, y equal to 0, fine, no problem. So mod of x, y equal to mod of 0, 0. So that is equal to 2, which is less than 3. No problem, absolutely okay. But x, y, you cannot take 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Then it will be 5. Okay. So you have to precisely choose the value for x and y such that these conditions are satisfied. That is the thing that you have to do. So now we have taken this particular example and all the conditions are satisfied. Now what we need to do, we need to find out a value for I such that x, y to the power I, z does not belong to L. Does not belong to L means it will not be in the format of 0 to the power n and 1 to the power n. What is 0 to the power n and 1 to the power of n? That certain number of 0 followed by exactly equal number of 1. Okay, so let us see. We take I equal to 0. Okay, and what we get x, y to the power I, z, that is x, y to the power 0, z. Y to the power 0 means y vanishes, so it will be only x, z. And what is x? We know that x equal to 0, 0. And what is z? We know that z equal to 1, 1, 1. So what is the value of x, z? 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. That means 0 to the power of, 2, 1 to the power of 3. Definitely that does not belong to L. Similarly, again, we take a value for I equal to 2. So what we get, x, y to the power I, z, that is x, y square, z, right? And x, y square, z means x, y, y, z, and the value of x equal to 0, 0, okay? The value of x equal to 0, 0. The value of y equal to 0. So what is y, y? 0, 0. So total there are 4, 0, and then followed by z. So that is 0 to the power of 4, 1 to the power of 3. That definitely does not belong to L. So we find the two values for I, 0 and 2, for which x y to the power I z does not belong to L. What does it mean? It means that our original assumption that L is a regular as language, that was basically a wrong assumption, a false assumption, right? So we come to the conclusion that L cannot be a regular language. Okay, so now in the second, I have given the generalized approach. This approach you will get in standard books like KLP Mishra. You follow the approach, it is the same thing. Instead of taking a particular value, I have taken a value for K, right? So there are four to five problems which are very important in pumping lemma. I have given another example so that a to the power I square is not a regular language. A to the power I square means the total number of I will be in perfect square. For example, a to the power of 4, a to the power of 9, a to the power of 16, a to the power of 25, and so on. Just imagine if I ask you to design a finite automata which accepts only perfect square number of a, can you design it? If you think logically, this is simply impossible. Okay, so now how do we prove it using pumping lemma? Once again, the strategy will be same, x, y to the power I, z, you have to show that this does not belong to language. Okay, how could you show? The mod of x, y to the power I, z, that is the length of the string, it has to be a perfect square. What is the length of this string, a to the power I square? How many times a is here? I square times, that is a perfect square. So a will come either 4 times or 9 times or 16 times or 25 times or 36 times and so on. Okay, so how could you prove? What is your strategy? Your strategy will be to take a value for I such that x, y to the power I, z is not a perfect square. How do we show it is not a perfect square? The strategy is simple. There cannot be any perfect square in between n square and n plus 1 whole square. Suppose n equal to 5. So n square is 25, n plus 1 whole square is 36. There cannot be any perfect square which is greater than 25 and less than 36. So from 26 to 35, there cannot be any perfect square. Okay. This strategy we take. Okay. We take two value, y greater than 0. We use this thing to prove that it is greater than n square, x, y square, z. The value for I is 2 here. Again, y less than equal to n, because x, y, mod of x, y is less than equal to n. So y has to be less than equal to n. We prove, we take the help of this thing to prove this thing. Yeah. So you go through these class notes. I think the idea will be clear. Ultimately, our aim is to prove that x, y square z, that length is greater than n square but less than the perfect square of the next integer, that is n plus 1 whole square. Okay, so it will be in between 16 to 25 or 26, 25 to 36, in between this. It cannot be a perfect square. Okay, so this is also another strategy. Okay, please see the solution of this thing in your book, that a to the power p, p is prime. Imagine if I ask you to design a finite automata which will accept only prime number of a, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and it will reject if it has a non-prime number of a. That is simply not possible. Logically, this is not possible. So pumping lemma, how do we prove it? Once again, I have to take a value for I such that x, y to the power I, z, that length is not prime. Now, how could we prove that that length is not prime? Simply, you have to show that it is a product of two numbers. 15 cannot be a prime because it is product of 3 and 5. That technique we use. Please go through KLP Mishra to find out the solution for this. And there is another important problem that a to the power n, b to the power of m, such that GCD of n comma m is 1. That is, n and m are relatively prime. That is also an important problem. I will tell you that there are 4 or 5 important problems on pumping lemma. One is this one. Another is this one. Another is this one. They are the very trademark problem. Okay, so if you practice this problem, I think you will feel yourself confident. So guys, I hope that you have got the basic concept of pumping lemma. Now, please go through my notes once again. If you have any problem, you can WhatsApp me. Okay, so in my next video, I will explain the other concepts from any other topic from regular language and regular expression. Okay, see, bye.